Hey guys, it's Peaches and welcome back to the Little Boxes Project. This is the Sims 4 series where I rebuild every single lot from every world in the Sims 4 for a future save file that I'm putting together. And today it is a very exciting day because we're finally on our last lot in Willow Creek, which is the park. It's Magnolia Blossom Park. And I did struggle a little bit with this one because I did consider making just building a new park from zero several times, and nothing that I did really turned out how I wanted. I didn't know how to fill the space, which is usually my problem with parks. But then I decided to just renovate the original Magnolia Blossom Park, and I'm really glad I did because I do really like how it turned out in the end. And as you can see right now, I am I'm modifying a lot this thing building that was, it was bathroom before, but in front of this very same lot there is a public bathroom already, like one of these world tiny ones that's like a rabbit hole. And I figured it was a little silly to just have two bathrooms, I don't know, like this really fancy bathroom and then a bathroom like right in front of the lot. So I made this building into a botanical garden, and it has a glass roof and the light goes through and it shows all of the beautiful patterns on the floor, and it looks really pretty. And I think it's a good cool place if you ever want to host, I don't know, a small wedding inside or something. I don't know, I really like the idea of making a botanical garden for a long time. And I actually, that was one of the ideas of for this park at first, like from making it from zero, if that makes any sense. But it was, I don't know, I just didn't know how to fill a space around then, and I just figured that it was better to just, I don't know, renovate the weird fancy bathroom in this place. But anyways, this was also a really good opportunity for me to mess around with all of the new debug items that we have. If you don't know anything about this, they actually, in the latest update, they unlocked all of the background items in every single world, and so you can just find them in the debug menu. And they don't cost any money, so for building starter homes is actually really handy because there is a ton of things in there that you can use as the core, including like fences and things like that, and they're all free. So that's the other thing that I would like to do in the future, is go through all of my starter homes in the save file and maybe add some more landscaping, because a lot of these lots, the only issue I have is that they're really bare and there's nothing around them. And some of them I even would like to like put some fences and stuff like that, and now I can do that, which is really cool. So here in a minute you're gonna see me pull out a bunch of new things, and I did change the type lot from park to national park, because national park only needs I think it's a grill, a picnic table, and I don't remember what else. It's like three things. You only need three things for a national park, and I wanted to just keep it really simple and not having to just, you know, put a ton of things that the park actually asks you to put. So here's where I'm starting to pull out the landscaping, and you will see me go through the menu a lot because it is hard to find things, and I am in the process of just putting rooms together with different items, like, I don't know, I think I uploaded a couple with city decor and another one with cars and boats and things like that, but I want to make a couple more with rocks and bushes and flowers and things like that, so I can easily find things, you know. I just have to open the gallery and find whatever I want, because there's a lot, especially if you own every single pack, there's a lot of things. So it is pretty entertaining to just go through and see all of the things. The other thing that you might notice is that there's things that are like chairs and tables and things like that, and those are just purely decorations. They don't work at all. So everything you put is free and it's purely decorative. It doesn't have any function or anything other than just fill the background. But there it is. It looks really nice. And especially those little plots, the one, the circle thingy that I put in them, like on the side where you just put the little tree, those are really cool for, like, I don't know, landscaping. But now that we have terrain tools, I guess it's easier to make. I don't know. But yeah, I am excited to finally be done with Willow Creek because it has taken a long time. If you think about it, I started this project, or I started posting this project already a year ago. Or I started building, at least. And we've only done 2 worlds so far. So I'm excited to finally move along. The next world we're gonna jump into is Newcrest. And it is a lot smaller than Willow Creek and Oasis Springs. It is only 14 lots, and Oasis Springs and Willow Creek are like 22, 24, something like that. And then we have Windenburg, which is like 28. It's a little bit ridiculous, and that one is going to take us a while to go through. But I've already built a few things in Windenburg. I have, I don't know, maybe 2/3 of Newcrest finished, mostly community lots. I've been struggling a little bit with the houses, with the residential lots, because I wasn't sure what style should I build the world in. I kind of decided to go for a more, I don't know, classic, what's that called? Suburban, like North American suburban type of house, more likely. Like, I wanted to go for a very weirdly perfect neighborhood, if that makes any sense. Like, it's a little not appropriate for your most of you probably, but there's this show called Weeds, and when at the beginning of the show they are living this really weirdly perfect neighborhood, and it's a little annoying, and that's kind of what I was going for Newcrest. It's very perfect, very symmetric, and I think the first lot I will show you guys is gonna be the park, actually. We're gonna finish with a park, and we're gonna start with a park, and it is very symmetric and very perfect. I really like it, actually. It's a little weird, but I like it a lot. But yeah, after I'm done with Newcrest, that will be the end of all of the base game worlds, and I will jump onto the worlds as, like, the order they released, if that makes any sense. So I was thinking I should start with Magnolia Promenade, which is the world that came with Get to Work. But I just remembered that before Get to Work, we did get Granite Falls with Outdoor Retreat. So I will probably go and start with that one afterwards. Probably. I'm not sure. They're really small worlds. They're like 5 lots each, so I'm not too worried about it. But I want to go in order. So after that one, after those little ones, I will probably go and start building on Windenburg, which is huge. It's gigantic. I'm a little worried about that one. I will probably struggle a little bit. We're not gonna finish this save file in 5 years, but I don't know, it's part of the fun, isn't it? Have a long-term project. But I want to finish it, that's for sure. By the way, before I forget, the picnic tables that I used from Cats and Dogs, the game does not see them as picnic tables for some reason, so it kept telling me that the venue was not complete. And what it did is to pull out this umbrella from the debug menu and merge it with the base game picnic tables that were already in this lot. So that's a little tip for you. If you don't own Cats and Dogs, you can do that and have the same table. Ta-da! Simple. But we are kind of getting close-ish to the end, so I wanted to talk to you guys about a couple of things. First of all, you're seeing this on Friday, so tomorrow, Saturday, Irrelevant Sams and I are announcing a really, really exciting collaboration. We will be announcing the theme and more or less what we'll be doing, so stay tuned. If you do not follow us on Twitter, you should. I will link her channel and her Twitter. I will link her channel and her Twitter down below in the description box and also in the I on the top right corner of the screen. But I am really excited about this because I've been wanting to collab with her for a long time, and I finally hit her up and she was like, I have this idea, and I was like, okay, got it. So I'm pretty excited to finally be announcing it, and yeah, just keep an ear to the ground for that. And the other thing is that I'm almost done with my gameplay of The Secret of Monkey Island. If you are not watching it, you should, because it's really fun. I'm having a lot of fun with it. But I'm almost done with it, and I've been asking you guys on Twitter and on the community tab on YouTube, what should I play next? And I will also link that thread in the comments/description box for you guys to check it out and vote. Although I already know what's going to come out, because a couple of you suggested for me to play Doki Doki Literature Club. That's a hard word to say. And it looks like it's winning, so keep an eye on that gameplay, I guess. It's too bad. I mean, it's not bad. I think it's interesting. I've never played that game before. I don't know what's about. I mean, I sort of know what's about, but I don't really know much about it. So I guess it is exciting to play a new game for once, and a game that you guys kind of want to see me playing. So it is kind of exciting, and even my husband was like, if you play that game, that will be the first time I actually watch your videos all the way through, because he fully supports my YouTube channel, but he's not into The Sims, so he does like my videos, but he never watches them. And this is the first time he said, you know what, if you play that game, bird, what the hell? So I just checked, and there is an owl outside my house, like right in front of my house. There's an owl, and there's a couple birds just screaming at her or him. I actually think it's a him. I call him Martin. He's been living around my house for a couple years now, but this is the first time he's like right on this side of the house in front of my window. So that's fun. What was I even saying? Yeah, just keep an eye for new gameplays, because that's gonna happen in the next few weeks. And I think we're almost done. Yeah, we're getting here to the end. We're just placing some more lights and the last few little details. And as always, the link for the slot will be in the description box. And I would like you to comment on this video, which was your favorite lot in Willow Creek. And yeah, you know what's up. Leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys on the next video.